one when we got together was trying to find a finite district that we can call, what is the smallest area that we want to address as a system? Is it a service? Is it a township? We realized that in a lot of the rural areas, EMS is provided by township fire districts. That's too many. We want to standardize throughout the state. It's tough enough deciding that we're going to standardize with 99 counties. When you start breaking it into the township level, it gets a little bit convoluted. So in Des Moines County, I want to talk about, that's where I came from before I moved up to Webster County. We had trying to develop the system standards and doing it at the county level. I went to each of the county board of supervisors individually, because if you meet together, they have to have meeting laws and all that. And they kept telling me, well, that's not our responsibility, it's the townships. The first responders respond in the fire districts, you need to talk to them. And so when I talked to them, they're like, well, the county is the one that needs to do this. It wasn't until I asked for a meeting of the township trustees at a county supervisors meeting, and I was told that was the first meeting that they've ever had as a complete body, that the township trustees stood up and said, we want the county to guide us in this. And then that opened the door for our system development group to write a resolution that the county adopted, recognizing the county EMS association as the authority in the county to make decisions on EMS in the county. That relieved the county board of supervisors from the responsibility, or at least their perceived responsibility, of managing EMS, because they really don't want it. And then the next thing they said, who's going to fund this? And it wasn't until we were able to say, we're already doing it. Let us build the system. If we need funding, we will come collectively to you and tell you what our needs are, instead of individual services coming. So the reason the example that I'm giving is that it takes relationship building. It takes conversations from individual services that want to see improvement, addressing this at the county level and making those relationships. One other point I'd like to make is Des Moines County has expanded now as far as providing system development, because to the north, and I'm sure we're going to talk about this a little bit, Louisa County has adopted some of the standards of Des Moines County, and they did that as a subgroup of Louisa County. The entire county isn't a system, it's just the southern half. So the system doesn't necessarily have to be the entire county. It can be whoever's willing to sit at the table and start working the process. Those that don't want to be part of the system initially, they can continue to do and provide the services that they're providing, but those that are willing to work together, I would encourage you to do so.